And Amar Singh has been recognised as Australia's local hero for his work supporting Aussies in need. His charity Turbans for Australia has helped fire and flood victims, as well as vulnerable people impacted by COVID. It also delivers 450 food packages a week to the needy in Western Sydney.
I'm a man who fought to find his place in Australia. Against lonely and isolation times, coming to a new country with a suitcase as a 15-year-old, and here am I today. God damn it.
God damn it, here he is with us now. It's Amar Singh! I was going to ask how it feels, but that smile pretty much answers my question, doesn't it?
That's it, mate.
Congratulations. Extraordinary effort. And I know on that stage that you're surrounded by incredible people. How did it feel when they announced your name?
It was humbled to be announced as Australia's local hero among so many incredible Australians from right around the country. And I got to make new friends. We spoke about a lot of things, what's happening in each other's lives and organisations, what are we working on. But, I mean, you know, the last 4 or 5 days have been just amazing. They're super-duper good. I've never enjoyed Canberra so much.
Can you tell us a little bit about how Turbans for Australia started?
Turbans for Australia started in a very small way back in 2015 with me thinking we need to do something to address the racism and inequality in our society. And that's how it was. We started out on a pretty low-key basis just to help out during, you know, community events, putting up water stalls, fruits and whatnot. But since the bushfires, we've just sort of taken, you know, on level 10, where we're just up and up, bushfires, COVID, floods, COVID, you name it, we're there.
Do you know what's fascinating listening to you is you, like a lot of other people in Australia, would have had experiences of racism. You did. That's the point. Some people respond to that by being angry and they want to go down a path of protest, resistance, etc. You, for whatever reason, have decided to go in a completely different direction, which is one of responding through, I don't know, giving and generosity. Why did you decide to take that road? Like, what was it that made you think that's the best response here?
Well, look, there's a few there, mate. I mean, we have some deadly spiders, so I didn't want to hide in some dark room and pretend the world doesn't exist. I'll be still cleaning cobwebs off my beard. And let's just go and, you know, get out there, have a go, and that's what the Fair Society is about. So I said, let's get out and make new friends, challenge some issues, and this is where we are today. I mean, you tell me, have we gone wrong?
Well, I mean, now you're a famous guy. There's going to be a lot going on your plate. What does the next year look like for you and your team?
We're going to keep doing what we do because that's what I love to do. Help Australians, highlight the issues of regional Australians, Aboriginal people. Let's all work towards a harmonious society. I know we're not going to get it all right 100%, but we have to actually try and make a difference. It's that, you know, inch by inch, mate. They're the little things at a time, and let's hope we can change society a bit by bit and make it a better place. That's my whole intention. I don't know, I could be wrong, but then you never know if you don't try.
Amar, you are an inspiring dude. I think everyone can see that. It's been great to speak to you. Congratulations again, and we look forward to seeing everything that you achieve over the next, well, however many years it might be. If you want to find out more information on Turbans for Australia, you can head to our website. Amar, thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thank you, Willie. Thank you, guys.